Okay, good morning, Pastor Archie.
Good morning, Sir Ginos. Sinigid nga aga sa atong online ministry.
1 John chapter 4, verses 1 to 6. It says, "Beloved, do not believe every spirit, but test the spirits to see whether they are from God. For many false prophets have gone out into the world. By this you know the Spirit of God. Every spirit that confesses that Jesus Christ has come in the flesh is from God." So makita rin sa verse ngayon niya, it is important for us to test every spirit, every words na mabatihan natin for as we go on in our Christian life. So many, since nowadays, we are living in the end times already. Can we consider our times already as end times, Pastor? Pwede ba na, di ba?
Sakto na. Church age.
Yes, okay. So makita natin nga, since we are living already in the end times, damo mga false prophets. So it's a mandatory for us to test every spirit and to check if we are in the right track pa as a Christian. That's why it is important for us to talk about salvation, because salvation, I believe, is a crucial part in our Christian life. Our end goal here is to determine if we are really in God's mercy. Okay. So as we start, I have here questions prepared for you, Pastor. And
okay.
Ikaw na bahala. Okay, kung ano in our first question.
Thank you, good sa matahong nga pamangkot, no, Sir Chinos. In regards sa question, what is salvation, or the point of view of the scripture or the Bible about salvation? Could we also ask what is the Christian doctrine of salvation, or what is salvation in biblical perspective? Now, makita natin dira, first of all, we must consider unagid that salvation is unilateral. When I say unilateral, from the scripture, siling sa Biblia, salvation is of the Lord, or salvation belongs to the Lord. So, by definition, the word salvation, actually, in theology, it comes from the word soteriology. The word soterio means salvation, logi means study. So, it is the study about salvation. How can a person be saved? Kagdiri makita natin that when we say salvation, it is a divine deliverance from sin and God's wrath. There is the word divine, because salvation is of the Lord again. Ito ang kaluwasan niya, iyas ang Diyos mo. Klaro sa Biblia that no one can come to me unless the Father draws him. So ang kaluwasan, panghikot niya sa Diyos. Kung ang Diyos hindi manghikot sa isa katao, why sin sinuman nga maluwas? And after all, the Bible is saying that Christ came for sinners. And that is actually gahampal sa atin, that all of us, Romans chapter 3, verse 10 to 11, for all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God. No one is righteous, no, not one. No one understands nor seeks after God. So, isa sa mga bagay pagid, when we say salvation, it is a salvation from danger and suffering, to save is to deliver, protect. Iluwason ka, proteksyonan ka. And the word carries the idea of victory or health or preservation. And sometimes the Bible uses the words save or salvation to refer to temporal or physical deliverance. Kung madumduman mo to sa Philippians, nga si Pablo naghambal dira about sa jailer, nga sa diin naghambal ang jailer, say, what must I do to be saved? Kag naghambal si Apostle Paul, kasi lang niya, repent and believe. and thou shalt be saved. Now, dira ng mga bagay, makita natin, it is very clear that salvation, again, is a divine deliverance. It is not something about physical. Why na iagahambal sa physical nga status ang tao, kundi sa spiritual nga status ang tao. And when Paul refers to the jailer and told the Philippian jailer, what must I do to be saved? He was referring to the jailer's eternal destiny. Ito kung mabasa natin in the book of Acts, chapter 16, 30-31, naglaro dira nga sang dito sila na priso, apart para maintindihan ta ang sitwasyon gid amo ini. Nga ang jailer, kung ikaw ang nagabantay, ang matabo actually, kung ang mga priso makapalagyo, piho, ikaw nga nagabantay, pansyon ka man. Now the point, sa amo nga chimpo, nagsiling si Pablo, hindi pagpatsay mo ko galingon, kasi hanayan na pansyon. Kaya abihan, nagpalagyo na sila. So, kung ang ininga jailer nagatumod about physical salvation, hindi na kinahanglan, kahit kaya harap malang si Paul and the rest ng mga prisoner. So, why is it nagsiling sa, what must I do to be saved? It is because nakita niya that it is beyond. It is about eternal state of man. Agahambal iti, dali, nga sa diin, something that naga-convict sa iya that he need not only physical salvation but eternal salvation. At amo ning ginahambal yung tri nga salvation which is divine. So by definition, when you say salvation, it is unilateral. It is God's means of grace. It is the work of God and God alone. Hindi na iya siling natun nga bilateral or masiling ka pala nga, okay, matuo ka, ihimuon mo amo ni, tapos kung himuon mo ni, mahimo ka mayad, grasyahan ka sang Ginoo, agud maluwas, no? Ang Biblia, klaro ka tama, in the book of Ephesians chapter 2, verse 8-9, for by grace you are saved, through faith, not of works, lest anyone should boast. So ang kaluwasan, tandaan ka, it is unilateral. It is the work of God alone in the dead soul of man. Amo maning mga theologian nagasiling actually sa libro ni Skogal, the life of God in the dead soul of man. Ang kabuhi sang Diyos sa patay nga kalagsang tao. Knowing that for all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God, we need salvation, and this salvation is a divine deliverance from sin and God's wrath.